What's good, y'all? Welcome back to a brand new episode of Reacts. Get back with Hirawaka. We finally have the dub of episode 5 for Hirawaka season 7, man. I am actually, as you guys can tell, recording this on Sunday instead of Saturday because my review for the episode yesterday took literally the entire day to edit. It was such an arduous process to record it, man. Oh, God, man. This is going to be rough. But anyway, guys, So yeah, we're finally doing the episode, man, and so yeah, let's see what we got. This is obviously, I actually almost forgot to even do this reaction until I saw someone post on Twitter, like, oh, like, the Uraraka, you know, Uraraka, he's a goosey. I was like, oh, shit, that was this way? Okay, I better react to this episode. So here we are, man. Let's see what we got for this episode, man. I'm excited to see Lucy and Justin's version of this scene. It's going to be awesome. Anyway, let's just jump right in. 3, 2, 1, go. Time to get some Leanne Clark up in here! Blood. Scum. Accepted her. The league accepted that side of her. Control yourself. I'm telling you this for your own good. Like readjust, trying to readjust this. Alright, whatever. That'll do. This is so fucked up. Bro, imagine having to get the blood out of those sheets, man. Ugh. Probably the most normal thing Toga's ever done.
Don't know what you mean.
I mean, are you ready to end this pathetic play?
I've always been ready.
That's the spirit. Whether you spend today laughing or crying, tomorrow will come just the same. In which case, we should laugh, don't you think?
Don't know why you just felt like burning her house down, but maybe you just felt like burning shit. I am very curious to know when Toga's gonna use that, because you know she is. It's only a matter of time before she uses it. Yeah. Bro, Machiavelli's War Machine is gonna be so fucking awesome. Yes, the CGI fingers.
You okay?
So the it just knows that like saliva stuff on there. What the hell is that? What the hell is that suspicious liquid? Is that sweat? God, I love a good dolly zoom. I completely forgot to mention that in my review of the episode, but I love that dolly zoom.
Spinner, since you're a heteromorph, you likely know the overlap of those who are like you and the ones labeled villains. No matter how hard the government or the crows try, they can't eliminate every shadow in society. Many heteromorphs hold a grudge against the so-called heroes because of it. Those of us who remain must pave the way forward. When the League of Villains first made the news, the public was exposed to reform. And along with Common Skin's costume, many heteromorphs now wear it in reverence to you.
I don't know why they'd idolize me. It's not like a fight for something to cost anything.
I have one goal. The die has already been cast. Forget about the jail.
The die is cast! You gotta say it right, man! The die is cast! What the hell is that switch? That looks like a hard drive.
Yet they haven't warned the evacuees of this imminent attack. So, Chaos, ensure that Izuku Midoriya is not welcome within their stronghold.
Those of us who joined the search for the Liberation Front and the League of Villains were able to capture a number of jailbreakers. We weren't able to find the
actual like a gun just casually incinerating someone. Kyle Phillips, super amazing.
We should go to bed promptly. Our youthful resilience is our strength. We must ensure that we're taking care of our minds and our bodies.
I don't think a nap's the same thing as training.
And brush your teeth. Okay, hygiene is no joke.
I like that one more. I forget who the script adapter is for Hiro Akame, but yeah, he cooked once again. I'm here, coming in a completely normal chill way! Come on! I'm so excited for that. Come on! Cassandra, let's go!
Now it's time for me to continue the fight.
Your safety is our chief concern, so keep your eyes peeled. Don't forget, evacuation system could activate at any time.
Don't forget the activation system at any time. Is that legit how he's always talented? He's never that much screen time, so I completely forgot. He's so familiar. I wonder if he's voicing him. Shoji. Yes. Harry and Kota finally meet. Let's go. I really wish that got expanded and we actually got to hear them talk. But hey, we got the hey, I got to hear a little bit of Cassandra this episode, so that's nice.
We're calling Troy.
Troy. Man, it's 2 for 2. All right, showtime. Why is she wearing a shirt over a hero costume?
You're strong and brave, and that hairstyle looks great on you. You're kind, cool, and nice to everybody.
That's not what I meant.
Why is she wearing a shirt over a hero costume? Like, what exactly is the purpose of this?
I said some stuff to her that seemed like common sense to me.
It was.
Unspeakable things. I saw a little too, you know.
Sure, but I don't think we can compare our families. It's strange.
Yeah, your brother's a cripple.
Definitely Udon. Kind of burns your mouth.
In that case, maybe I'll have to eat some with him.
That was nice. Yeah, Des Girls new render! Let's go! Drip!
Lies do not work on me. I can tell if someone has the slightest bit of deceit in their minds. What was the name of that ability? I took it in the early days of quirk appearances.
Yes, let me take your bullshit detector! His descendants. Is Beck keeping tabs on them on their Facebook pages?
They drove me into a corner. But now, the lie detecting quirk will help to ensure my victory. There is no greater joy than seeing a seed you planted bear fruit.
We are doing quite well here.
I've been craving a drink. 40 years.
Never know what the filter holds.
No lies are filled with. She's clear.
She's clear.
She's interrogated later for some reason. She'll pose no problem for me. This will be the last time we have to use these idiotic codes.
Perhaps tomorrow?
You must have a very good lawyer.
I think we should talk alone first. It's kind of funny. The courts are still in session, even though everything's crumbling. Maybe people are clinging to the old ways as long as they can before this way of life ends. What are you saying? Would you like for me to tell you all for one's true goal?
Please! The floor is yours, Aoyama! Weirdly topical for Horikoshi to put that in there, because with the manga, because the yen was actually decreasing. I'm pretty sure it was starting to go down value when this chapter came out, judging from, I mentioned in my review from the figure collectors I follow on YouTube or subscribe to, mentioning about that a couple years back.
You're telling me this right now, Aoyama. When states lose the ability to enforce law and policies, people struggle to survive. War and poverty run rampant. Soon, countries everywhere will abandon each other because they need to prioritize their own safety. Imagine if a forsaken country was ravaged by drought and someone appeared who had a quirk that could create drinking water, or electricity, or gas, or raw power. As the Earth slips further into anarchy, the stage is prepared for one unrivaled opportunist to take initiative and assume control over all that exists. You will be crowned the demon.
The power of the sun in the palm of my hand.
Our world will fall off balance.
It sounds bad, but you're wrong. People wouldn't allow that to happen. And besides, we're still here defending Japan.
I know. That's why you're here. This can't be allowed to keep going. I'm sorry. I had no choice. I want to protect Papa and Mama.
You didn't!
Excellent job. Imagine how scared your betrayal that is. It can be so distressing to have someone put their faith in me, not. Your form is impressive. And there's
one, man. He's just unrelenting. Austin. Cooked once again. Lucy and Justin were both phenomenal, and Leanne was great too. Let's go! Oh, Wash's in there too! I just noticed her! Yeah! Shinso! Let's go! Phenomenal episode, man. The dub was absolutely fantastic. And yeah, man, that's going to this video off. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. Like if you did, subscribe if you're new. Follow me on socials if you feel like it. Links and subscribe below. And as always, bye for more. See you guys next time.